the ticket and theticketfm.com.
Load up on meat and more this spring at the Mercado by Certified Piedmontese at 84th and Havelock. This week's specials through April 2nd is buy one, get one free on 8-ounce flat iron steaks. Limit 4 per visit. And don't forget about lunch on Fired Up Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Locations on 84th and Havelock and 30th and Yankee Hill in Lincoln or 168th and Maple in Omaha. Get to the Mercado today for the best meat in town.
Spring is on its way. Are you prepared to keep the grass greener on your side? Blades Lawn and Landscape has a position opened at a homeowner association to their client list with residential and commercial openings also. Transform your yard into a private oasis with the professional services offered by Blades Lawn and Landscape, including landscape walls and beds and a five-step fertilizer program applied by a licensed professional. Call them today at 402-730-6320 or go to bladeslcc.com to schedule a free estimate on commercial or residential lawn services.
Your business runs like a well-oiled machine. It's important that your actual machines do too. Stern is here to make sure you don't have to worry about that. They provide solutions for heavy equipment and automotive fuels, lubricants, and equipment guard options. And with Stern's commitment to customer service for the past 40 years, you know you have a partner to help support your operations for years to come. Contact Roger at Stern Company by calling 1-800-477-2744 or visit them online at stern.co. Stern Company, where problems meet solving.
Happy hour.
How's life treating you, man?
Here's why people don't really respond to your questions, Nick. Just, are we in the circle of truth? You really want to know why? Because yes. The feeling when you ask those questions is not very genuine. You really don't care about our feelings. You only care about Nick.
You make me sound so bad.
It is. You really only care about Nick.
I do care.
No, you do not.
If I didn't care, I wouldn't ask you. You only ask that question because it seems nice.
And you want to look good on the street.
Yeah, that's not it at makes, all. It makes you sound like a nice person. You don't care. You don't care.
You really was. It's cool.
Weekdays from 1 to 2 on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com. This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me, sure. Look at me, sure. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown. Vershawn Jackson. Number 34 gets the touchdown.
Terrell Farley. Defending Terrell Farley,
who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakovin.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
Turn me down. I'm too loud in Cam Jurgens' ear right now. Big Cam in the building. Listen, it's Thursday. Thursday, and I'm... Energy. Ever since your freshman year, I always said, and you play tight end.
Yep.
And I said to myself, if there's one guy out there that's running around like he don't care, hair on fire, it's Cam Jurgens. Why?
Because I didn't care. I mean, like, my journey in Nebraska was different than what I ever expected it to be. And it was a struggle at first. And, like, I had to go through a lot of stuff to get to where I am today. But yeah, I mean, I was like, when I first got to Nebraska, I was a tight end. I went in heavy. I was like 270 coming from a leg injury.
Yeah.
Went down to 250. I'm learning the offense. And then I get asked, like, right before week one, like, hey, we want you at O line next year. We think you can be our center. And I'm like, man, I don't know if I can do that.
but why did he think you could do it, though?
I think he saw the athleticism practice and the blocking.
In practice? I'm saying you was on scout team your redshirt year, right?
Yeah, yeah. I was on scout team. I was trying to be a menace in practice and go as hard as I can and do everything I could and show them, like, who I was.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, all right, well, let me think about this O-line deal. And, like, a week and a half later, I dropped 20 pounds. I was at 230. I'm like, maybe I just need to run faster. Yeah.
Somebody knew something, though. And when you look at that, I always say, okay, second round, 51st overall, right?
Yep.
Coming from tight end, going to a different position. But a lot of people don't know. In high school, you did multiple sports.
Oh, yeah. No, football, basketball, track. So I was
punter, discus, shot.
Yep. So I did everything in football except play O-line.
I'm just thinking, when I went through that, I'm like, dang, tight end, fullback, linebacker, punter. That was – and we talking 11, man.
Yeah.
Class C?
B.
Class B at the time. Okay, did you play in the Shrine Bowl?
No, I did. Well, I broke my leg, so I wasn't able to my senior year. So like, I was just trying to get healthy, and I'm like, I couldn't – wasn't clear to do nothing yet.
Yeah, yeah. So, okay, so walk me through it. You get a scholarship offer at Nebraska. You get here, it ain't necessarily you ain't the guy.
Mm-hmm.
You're just one of the guys that's playing on the team that got to go against these number one guys every day, right? You come back your next year. Now they ask you to play the position. Do you play or do you start?
So I started my second year when I went over. So I made that switch. Like I said, week one, they asked me to move over to center. And I was like, all right, well, let me think about it. I dropped weight to like 230. I'm like, all right, let me just become a better route runner, do everything I can to like stay here. I didn't know if I could hold that weight as much. And so week four, I go into the tight end room. They're like, yo, you're with the O-line today. So it's like, all right, well, I'm moving there anyway. And so I'm going through this process of switching over to O-line, learning how to be a center and do it. Everything's new to me.
Never played center before.
No, I mean, I did when I was in like third through fifth grade because I was too heavy to carry the ball.
Okay, okay.
So they had that stripe on the helmet.
Yeah.
Even though I was faster than all the other kids, I weighed too much.
Way too much.
And so I made the switch over to O-line. So I'm practicing at center, learning this new position. I break my foot. And so I missed out all the like crucial practice reps. And then I'm getting into after the season, getting into spring ball. I'm excited to get going. And then I turn around and break my other foot.
What?
So I miss out on most of spring ball there. I'm not getting any practice reps at center, but like I'm just doing mental reps. I'm learning everything, but physically I'm not able to do anything.
Yeah.
So mentally learning the position, get everything down, and comes around, fall camp's getting ready. And then I retweak one of my foots. And so I had to deal with that. So I didn't really practice most of fall camp. I look back on it, and I think I had like a week of healthy practice at center.
You still started.
And I started. And so I'm going in there not knowing what's going on. Like, I mentally knew, but it's like physically, I didn't know how to snap. Like, right. I was learning how to snap. Everybody in Nebraska is booing me saying, tension. And I'm like, yo, like, this is my first rodeo. Yeah, I'm like, yo, I'm new to this. So like that, I mean, just dealing with that mentally, dealing with all the fans and the hate.
Talk
and, like,
about that a little bit though, because I think fans need to hear from a player's perspective, right? How that affects you when, you know, what did you hear? What kind of noise did you hear?
Man, I heard just a little bit of everything, really? You know. There was very little positivity at that time because we're losing and they're looking for ways to put blame on people. And like, obviously the quarterback gets the blunt of it. And then it can go to me because snaps are bad and they were bad, but it's like, yo, I'm just learning how to do this. I'm new to it. And I don't think fans really understand that. And I get it. You know, they just want to win. Like that's how I was growing up. Like, we just want to win. So I mean, negativity isn't always the worst thing. Like, I get it. It made me better for it, you know, mentally stronger and getting able to, you know, overcome those things. Like, you know, I'm putting in work. If they're hating me or if they don't hate me, doesn't matter. It didn't change nothing. I'm still putting in the same amount of work. Like, I worked at it every single day. And, you know, I was like, all right, well, you know, we're going to get over this hump. And, you know, we did.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you did get over the hump, but going back to you in center, you know, you had your struggles early. But then later on, when I look at you and I say, and I've told you this 1,000 times, how come we can't get 5 Cam Jurgens on that offensive line? And it's not because you were the biggest guy. You were the most sound technique-wise. No, it was because you had the motor and the will to go. You didn't If somebody hit you in the mouth, you weren't going to take that lightly, were you?
No. And the thing, when I went into a game, it's like that mentality and that shift, like, you know what it is. Yeah. Like when you go in there, it changes. And I think people don't have that in them. And I'm like, yo, I didn't just have that. You know, you're not built.
Where
you're not
think
born
you got
with that.
It, though?
I mean, I got it. Like, I mean, obviously I grew up like on a farm, like putting in a lot of work. And so like I had that, you know, mentality of like hard work builds it. But like I built that in practice, you know, like I had a great O-line coach in Greg Austin. And like he really pushed us mentally to be like the strongest people we can be mentally. Since like, yo, it's not that tough. You know, if you really think about it, a football play lasts 4 seconds. Like, yo, can you give it your all for 4 seconds? Mm. And it's not that tough. Just being mentally locked in and doing, go as hard as you can for 4 seconds. It's 4 seconds. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's 4 seconds. So that's the mentality I took in practice. And if I'm going 100% in practice, the games, you're not thinking. You don't think about nothing. You're just doing. Your body takes over, and you're just going. Mm-hmm.
Who was your toughest teammate that you went against? You remember? Was it a guy that you just used to bang with?
In college?
Yeah.
Man, we had a lot of good D linemen. There were some tough dudes. You know, I think early
nobody,
on.
Nobody, y'all. Dude, Cam.
Like, we had good dudes, but yeah. Like, I.
Everybody did. Nobody deal with Cam, did they?
I mean, I felt like I took it to everybody there.
Oh, boy, I would have loved to play with you.
Yeah,
because the mentality of the guys that I played with on defensive line, y'all would have been banking. It would have been exciting football. And I got so much energy because I'd look at you and I'd be like, man, listen, Cam went from tight end to center. You didn't go from tight end to guard. Mm-hmm. You didn't go from tight end to fullback. You went from tight end to center to in the league. That's unheard of. You either are very smart because you got to pick up playing center. Everybody thinks snapping the ball. And, you know, when they see you do this and you put your head down, mm-hmm, and you snap it back, everybody thinks that's a science and they think it's easy to do.
No, I mean, I think it's like shooting a free throw. It's like, yo, any Joe Schmo from off the street can go shoot a free throw and make it. Like, anybody can snap a ball, but it's like, yo, when you're in the game and you're shooting, it's like it's all repetition, muscle memory, and like that, everything like a free throw, it's got to get built. You know, you can have good form, you can do it correctly, but can you repeat it? And so obviously that gets better over time. That's how I would compare to it. You know, there's different strategies and techniques to it, and you're going to learn different ways to do it, but you just got to get reps in. That's the end of the day.
How long have you wanted to be a Husker?
Oh, my whole life. I mean, my whole life. I grew up idolizing guys in the league and, well, guys in college at Nebraska. And like going through the draft process, people, all the teams would ask me, it's like, yo, what's your favorite NFL team growing up? And I'm like, I didn't have one. Like, what are you talking about? Like I thought it was funny. And I'm like, yo, I just watched Nebraska, and every single guy from Nebraska that went to the league, I watched them.
Right.
And so, yeah, I was a Lions fan because Sue played there.
Right.
It's like, I was a Bucks fan because Avante David played there. It's just like, yo, I just follow like those Cornhuskers.
Yeah. I'm the same way. Somebody asked me, who's my favorite team? Oh, I don't have team. I got players, and I go with the players. Like, I'm a Philly. I'm a super Philly fan now. Now, why? Not only because they got Cam there, but now you're starting to get some guys that I know too. You know, mm-hmm, with Devin White, with getting Saquon Barkley, I think was phenomenal. Can you talk a little bit about that Saquon deal? I mean, have you watched him run the ball and blocking for him? I would think would be a delight.
Man, who hasn't watched him run? Who hasn't been like, like he's a beast.
Yeah.
He is a beast, and I'm fired up to be blocking for him this year. You know, that's going to be a huge addition to the room. Everything I hear about him is great stuff. Super smart dude, and just, man, he can run that ball, and he is strong, physical, and that's what you want in a running back. Like, we can take over a game with him, and
right,
you know, I feel like we had a great running back last year, Swift, and you know, I wish, obviously, every old lineman's going to be the same. Like, yo, let's run the ball more, you know, and now we got Saquon, it's going to be the same thing. Like,
right,
let's run that ball.
All right,
fan question, and then I'm gonna let Bach jump in here, and then we'll get you one more segment. We'll jump off air and get you one more segment. So, fans, because Carell Buchalter played for Philly, so we used to go to Philly all the time, go to the games. What's the difference between the fans in Philly and the fans in Nebraska?
Man, the fans in Philly, like, they're both great fan bases, but the fans in Philly are brutal. Brutal. Like, there's no Nebraska nice, Midwest nice out there. But, like, I come to the point, I love it. Like, we'll be 7-0, undefeated, and we'll be losing at halftime. We're getting booed going to halftime.
Dang.
Like, they just demand excellence. But they also, they're knowledgeable. Like, Nebraska is knowledgeable, but they're to a different level. They're like, they watch the game intently, and they'll be like, yo, he didn't have a good game, but man, you see him hustle out there. You see him work hard. Like, right. they notice that stuff. So, like, if you're a hardworking dude and you play hard, they're gonna be a fan of you.
Yeah. Oh, well, and they're a little aggressive too in Philly. They're a little aggressive. I went to a game and before you know it, who is Philly playing? Green Bay? I don't remember who it was. Before you know it, it was an all out brawl in the stands. Oh, and I'm talking it all the way up at the top. And I'm like, these people are really fighting in the game, during the game, banging.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was crazy.
I mean, what else would you want? You want to go play in L.A. and have nobody know who
you are?
Nah, like,
Philly, baby.
Come on now. You want a fan base that shows up and cares and has your back and will fight you, but will fight other people on your back.
Right,
you know, like,
right.
It is what it is. You know, you're going to get it both ways.
Who has been the toughest person to go against in the league?
Dexter Lawrence.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it because he's big and is he long or what?
He is so big, so powerful, so explosive. I mean, there's a lot of really good guys I played this year, but I'd say, you know, from that nose guard, like, nobody does it better than him.
Yeah.
And, you know, Chris Jones was really good too, obviously.
Right.
Stud. And then, you know, we got some really good guys on the Eagles, man, getting the block, Fletcher Cox. Man, I'm just so blessed. I got to play with him for 2 years, and he retired. Like, he's a legend, man. So I had a lot of really good players in practice that, you know, helped me get ready for games.
Well, I was going to talk to you about that. How important was it to have Kelsey as a big brother in that situation?
Man, he was great. He was incredible. Like, he was just a really good mentor, and everybody talks about Kelsey, and he is the best. Everything you think, it's that plus more. But, like, everybody in that room, the O-line coach, Lane Johnson, Jordan Mulata, Lana Diggerson, like, everybody in there was incredible to me. So it was a whole room effort.
Nice. Well, listen, we got Cam Jurgens. I ain't going to get too excited. We're going to have him one more segment, and he got to go work out. We're going to talk a little bit about the Jurgie. I'm going to give one of these away, too. I'm going to give one away. You got to come down here to get it, though, before he leaves. If you don't, I'm eating it, okay? And we're gonna try the mango habanero online when we get back. But I tell you what, we're power.
Power. Infrastructure.
Power.
Underground.
Brand.
Excavating.
Fastest 2 hours in radio has begun. I got the legend, Cam Jurgens, with me. We'll be right back.
Spring is on its way. Are you prepared to keep the grass greener on your side? Blades Lawn and Landscape has a position opened at a homeowner association to their client list, with residential and commercial openings also. Transform your yard into a private oasis with the professional services offered by Blades Lawn and Landscape, including landscape walls and beds and a 5-step fertilizer program applied by a licensed professional. Call them today at 402-730-6320 or go to bladeslcc.com to schedule a free estimate on commercial or residential lawn services.
Load up on meat and more this spring at the Mercado by Certified Piedmontese at 84th and Havelock. This week's specials through April 2nd is buy one, get one free on 8-ounce flat iron steaks. Limit 4 per visit. And don't forget about lunch on Fired Up Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Locations on 84th and Havelock and 30th and Yankee Hill in Lincoln, or 168th and Maple in Omaha. Get to the Mercado today for the best meat in town. The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Thursday, March 28th versus the Grand Rapids Rise at CHI Health Center in Omaha. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 6 p.m. with first serve at 7. Make sure to tune in to the next Ag Appraisal and Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas Radio Network.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you're passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
Life is all about balance, so how about a little sweet and a little heat to make your week? At Wings and Rings, we're introducing our all-new Hot Honey menu for the month of March. Try our one-of-a-kind house-made sauce on the brand-new Hot Honey Chicken Sandwich or our Hot Honey Shrimp and Slaw. And of course, you can get it on the traditional boneless or smoked wings that have made Wings and Rings your go-to neighborhood spot. But don't wait. Hot Honey is only here until April 1st. So stop by Wings and Rings at one of our two Lincoln locations today on O Street and on Village Lane.
At Southeast Community College, community is our middle name. Our continuing education classes offer personal interest, traffic safety and licensing, online learning, and adult education classes across Southeast Nebraska or online in your own home. Learn to ride a motorcycle, how to start a small business, how to dance, or take a course to advance in your current career path. See the full schedule of continuing education classes online at southeast.edu/continuing. SCC, your path to possible.
Action Plumbing, Heating, Air, and Electric is the call I make when I have a need for plumbing services. Whether it's for my home or office, if I need a repair to a water heater, softener, or even my garbage disposal, I know I can count on Action to help. In one simple call, their amazing customer service team promptly schedules a service call, often getting to my needs within a day. Action delivers honest, quality services we can count on. To learn more, visit actionlincoln.com.
Power Combo BOGO? Huh?
Yes. If you purchase an air conditioner, you receive a furnace completely free. At John Henry's, our professionals want to ensure you are comfortable in your home all year long, no matter what Nebraska has to throw at us. Call today to schedule your free estimate and learn more about the free furnace waiting for you. Give John Henry's a call today.
435-5555. John Henry's Plumbing, Heating and Air,
and Electrical.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
Empower a child today with the Teammates Mentoring Program. Hope is only a conversation away when you choose to share your talent, time, and heart with a child. Together, you can build a relationship based on strengths and chart a brighter future one week at a time. Find out how you can be a mentor by visiting lincolnteammates.org. Become what you needed as a kid by joining the Teammates Mentoring Program today.
Alcohol has strained our relationship. Drinking too much can cause harm to friends, family members, and loved ones. By drinking less, we will save our relationship. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Start your Sundays off right with Jeff and Nicole Essink on Fitness Fanatics. Jeff and Nicole discuss health and wellness, how to achieve fitness goals, and more through the life of gym owners and gym goers. It's Fitness Fanatics from 9 to 11 a.m. on Sundays on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Oh, I'm just going to come in no music. You all right?
You don't get the music?
I can't hear anything.
Well, yeah, you got music going.
No, I can hear that music, but I can't hear me now. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Well, I can't hear me. Jay, I don't like that, y'all. Anyway, I feel like I can. I'm talking to myself right now, but we are with Cam Jurgens, Philadelphia Eagles center, one of the best, I believe, offensive linemen to put the pads on here in Nebraska, just based on his mentality, his aggression. And obviously the NFL thought he was the exact same thing too. Because if they wouldn't, you tell me how many guys got drafted 51st overall and at Nebraska played O-line.
Yeah, I mean.
Not very many.
Not a ton. But no. We do have some great, great people in the past history at Nebraska.
Absolutely. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about my favorite. Because we were supposed to do this 2 years ago, right before you left. Mm-hmm. And we didn't get a chance to. So tell me about how the beef jerky, the jerky got started, and then let the people know how they can go get some of this mango habanero jerky.
Yeah, well, first off, you can get it on our website, jerky.co, J-U-R-G-Y.co. And so this all started in college. When NIL got passed, it was a fun thing. Nebraska, actually, our strength coach, Coach Duvall's daughter, Tanya, made me this beef jerky logo, and they made a little clip. And they're like, hey, you can use these logos for NIL. And then my mom ended up turned around, made a T-shirt, and we started selling T-shirts. And then we started partnering with a locker here in Nebraska and started making some jerky and selling it. And it was just a really fun thing to do. And then my partner at the time and my mom was helping out a ton. You know, she was our shipping department for us. And doing anything at the early part, she was making shirts. And then me and my partner, my right guard in Nebraska, former Husker, Matt Sichtman, he made the website for us. He's been helping out so much for the business. He's been basically running the show. A man is a genius, and he was a great right guard for us. We had a good year together. And so we made this jerky. And we got these new bags, these new flavors, and we partnered with a new jerky maker out in Pennsylvania. And this dude is incredible. So we got five flavors, mango habanero, original teriyaki, cracked pepper, hot honey, and they're all great. Mango habanero is my personal favorite, but it's just been, it's been such a fun project doing it. You know, I grew up deer hunting and going out with my dad and my brother and making jerky, and it's always been a passion of mine. And now going into the space of being an entrepreneur and trying to build like a business, it's so fun, especially keeping in touch with one of my best friends, Matt, and my mom, and trying to build this and make something of it. And, you know, there's so many times, especially when guys are in the NFL and then they get done playing football, they got nothing to do after.
Yeah.
And so you got to, so this is another thing I'm thinking. It's like, let's build this brand and build this jerky, so then like this is a fun thing for us to do, and so I enjoy it, and obviously the jerky's incredible. It speaks for itself. Like, you just gotta try it. And like we started in college, and it was fun, like trying to do this NIL thing, and we asked for help with like the NIL director, and we didn't get much help at it. And you know, me and Matt were like, well, let's just do it ourselves. Let's just figure it out. We're gonna learn as we go. And then we made this jerky brand. And then, man, you fast forward like 2 years later, there's two more jerky brands in Nebraska out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere.
And I'm like, man, we were asking for help from the jump and we didn't get none. But it's still fun, man. I love it. So hopefully you guys try it out, enjoy it.
Can you get it in stores?
So we're working on it. This is brand new. We've only had this new jerky for about a month now.
And really?
We're trying to lay the foundation and get everything ready. But yeah, it's all set up. Like we have it online, and we're trying to get in the stores right now. We're just starting to get our wholesale product set up, but it's exciting, man. So it's new. You gotta watch out. That mango hop got a kick. If you like a little spice, try that mango hop and hot honey.
I might got a little bit too much spice. But tell the people about the website one more time. If they want to get any of these flavors, they can go to who? Where do they need to go to? Do you got that up?
Yeah, check it out on jerky.com or jerky.co, jurgy.co. And you can also find it on my Instagram. Right. And we have Jerky Co. on Instagram and different social media products. So check it out, man. It's a great product. And, you know, it's two former Huskers and my mom that started it. And we're running the show now. So we're excited to get going. And, you know, it's cool, you know, going to different guys. Like, you talk about NIL, and a lot of times it's just like this company, an NIL company, giving athletes money. And that's about all it is. There's not too much. And it's like, we started this ourselves, and we figured out, we worked with another great resource we had was the UNL law students. We worked with their college over there, and we got help, you know, forming an LLC and making trademarks for the jerky and like making. So it was really like a Nebraska started business, and we're still getting help from the law students, and it's been a really fun. So that would be the entrepreneurship clinic over at the university, and they've been awesome.
See, you see that, Bob? See, I like the fact that you said I went from a concept, we put it as an idea, we used our resources, and we LLC'd.
Yeah. And it's so fun making this product because, like, we use so many people from Nebraska. The logos and a lot of the stuff on the bag was made by a designer, AJ Wiley. He's from Nebraska. He worked with the football team for a little bit and just design. And now he's in Colorado now working with North Face. Like, he is a big time designer. So, like, he killed it. You know, I think the bag looks incredible and it's just really fun. And we're excited to see where it can go now.
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't mind. Me and my brother own a restaurant. And so you can never get good beef jerky, really. I mean, the real beef jerky, those little sticks, ain't it? This is it. And I'm not just saying that. You gave me some last time, but this right here, fire.
Yeah. So the guy, the place that makes it is actually, we had to go out and we found a new place and made it out in Pennsylvania. And we met with these people, and this guy grew up Amish his whole life. And now, like, his parents own a butcher shop, and he's like, dude, I've been making jerky and working with meat my entire life. And so he's made a big business of it. And the stuff he makes is incredible. Like, I'm just excited to get it out there and have people try it.
No, it's good stuff. I'm a yield to Bach because Bach has been sitting here patiently because I'm a little greedy. I can take all your time and I don't want to do that. So I'm gonna let Bach ask you a couple questions and we'll get back to it. And then we'll cut you loose.
Well, I know the NFL season's about to get going, and this is the long term plan from the outside. Looks like you know, center for you. Is that definitely what you're going to play when you get into camp?
Yeah, you know, I'm going to move over to that center position, and I'm just excited for this year. You know, playing guard this last year was new to me. I've never played guard before, and they moved me over there, and that was a new experience, and I feel like I had a pretty good year there playing that guard position. So, I honestly feel a little more comfortable moving back to center, so I'm excited for that.
How's Jalen Hurts?
Man, he's good. He's good, man. He is just a fearless leader.
Yeah.
And I'm not like everybody in the building. Like, he is such a hard worker. He puts in more time than anybody else. Like, he's in the building all day long. You don't always see that from your quarterback,
right?
Especially a quarterback that's paid as high as he is.
Yeah,
they might not always put in the work, but he does. Man, he's a beast in the weight room. He's always in the film room, and he puts in a lot of time. And I think people see that and they respect that.
What's the difference in the speed, Baki? You can throw another one, but what's the difference in the speed in the NFL? I kind of loaded that question. Give me the differences between the NFL and playing at Nebraska.
So I would say, like, college ball, you know, you have a lot of good players, but there are some players that, like, maybe not as fast and as strong as some of the other players. When you get to the league, man, everybody's good. Everybody's good. There's no reps off, but you know, you see really good players in college too. Like, I would say, like, the speed of the game is similar. It really is similar, but where you differ is just the schemes, the schematics. I think people that, like, don't play the sport won't recognize that, but, like, the playbook is a lot more advanced. And when you get in there, you may go to the line with three different plays you can play, and you got to be dialed in. You got to know what you're doing, because if you don't, like, it happens so quick, and guys are, like, just amazing athletes that, like, it goes faster because you don't know what's going on.
Right.
So it is quick. It is very fast. It's high tempo. But, you know, you see really good players in college, but you have drop off. Where in the NFL,
no drop off.
There ain't drop off.
Cross the board.
It's cross the board. Up Everybody's here. A dog.
So how do you separate yourself to be in that elite of the elites? What sets you in that category?
I mean, obviously, you need to be a good athlete to be in the NFL. But then, like, it's just mentality. Like, we're talking, like, you got to be a dog. That when you, at the end of the day, you're just playing football. And you're playing football at the highest level. But, like, you need to have a strong dog mentality.
Yeah.
And we always talk about being the stronger team and being stronger than an opponent. And it's not, like, just – it's not about, like, hey, can you beat them on this play? Can you be tougher this play, like being the toughest team? It's not about being the toughest for one play. It's about being the toughest for that play, the next play, the play after that. Man, it's a long game. You're going to get there. You're going to get either 50 snaps or 90 snaps, maybe, like, who knows? But, like, it's about who's the toughest, the longest. Yeah. So that's what it is. And it's a long game. It's a long season. And it's not how you play the first play. It's how you play every play.
Now, I played in the league, of course, not as long, nowhere near as long as you're going to play, but I played. I got my 2.5 years. Is it more bleep talking in college or the pros? And who was the biggest bleep talker that you had to deal with?
Definitely more in the pros. People are talking all the time. And I'm not really talking unless I get talked to or unless I throw somebody on the ground. You know, like,
yeah.
I'm conserving energy. You know, I'm going hard. I'm breathing heavy. Like, I ain't going out there talking every play. But the biggest trash talker is Brandon Graham. He's on our team. That dude's on another level. And it could be about anything.
Really?
All practice long. He ain't just doing it in the games. He'll be talking to a 4-string tackle on the scout team saying he's working it. Like, he ain't got nothing going on. You know, he's just like, bro, it's hilarious. And he's going into, I want to say it's 14th or 15th season. Like, he's been there forever. And that dude hasn't lost a beat in the trash talking department. I'll tell you that.
I missed that part of football.
Yeah,
you know, I think sometimes we get so caught up in trying to get things done the right way that we take the fun out the game. And if NFL guys that are making hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars, if you guys can relax and have some fun, I think everybody needs to take note and do that, because football's got to be fun too.
It is.
I get when you get to the NFL, it's a business, but it's still fun to you, right?
It's got to be. You know, if it's not fun, you ain't going to last in the league.
Yeah.
And especially when you're in them fall camp practices, you're in training camp and them meetings, you're on hour three or four meetings of the day. Man, like, you
got to
have
that, though,
something fun in the room, and you got to have some funny guys in the room. You need something. You need some humor.
Right.
You need something to light up the room. Otherwise, like, it's so stagnant if you don't. And you need to have fun with it. Otherwise, you're going to be miserable.
What did you have to do something? You had to do a skit at the rookie deal?
Oh, yeah. I had to go up and sing in front of the whole team.
What did you
sing? I sang the first night of it. I went up there and sang.
What'd you sing?
Man, I went up there saying Country Road by John Denver.
Come on, give us some Country Road by John.
Smoked it.
Give us some Country Road by John Denver.
Oh, man, I can't do it on air. It's a close. It was so good. It had to be done behind closed doors.
Really?
We can't have that in the public.
All right. That's fair.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. I got no rhythm, man. I got nothing. So I was just going up there, giving passion, singing loud. You know, it's just about being loud.
Right.
That's what it is.
Yeah. I mean, just see, Bach, y'all be talking stuff about me being loud. Cam just told you it's about being loud.
Loud. Being and loud is confidence.
You got any other questions?
Well, I know my favorite memory of you as a Husker was, I think it was pushing Oklahoma Sooner downfield 20 yards or so. What was your favorite memory of being a Husker? Somebody off the text line wanted to ask.
My favorite memory of being the Husker, I think it was just being a Husker, man. Like, I grew up idolizing these guys. Like, hey, they were like my biggest role models. And so for me to be a Cornhusker and playing that football team and actually, like, be the one that people are looking up to, I mean, that in itself is, like, the best thing I could have had. And obviously I had great relationships and met so many guys there. So I think that's awesome. I mean, you meet guys from all over the country and you form those bonds and those relationships. And even, like, players in the past, you know, you go to Nebraska, you're a Cornhusker for life. And I got brothers throughout time and history.
Yeah. But, you know, to go with that, and I kind of know where you were going with that. me and you kind of had the same mentality as far as blocking goes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Where if the whistle ain't blown, I don't care where I got you. I got you. I don't care if I got you downfield, I'm going to take you to the sidelines. But that mentality, how do we get that mentality back into the offensive line now? Because I think for me, being a part of the Hogs, being a part of that, those guys, and I always ask myself, well, which guy could play with, you know, Stye, Wiegert, all those guys? Who could play with them? And it ain't a lot. So what do we got to do as far as Nebraska football to have all five guys have that same type of mentality?
I think it's built in the offseason. You know, if you got the right guys in the building, obviously you got to recruit and get good dudes in there. But, you know, you can grow that. You can grow that in the offseason and practice and like I did. But I don't know, man. At the end of the day, you got to have maybe a screw loose in your head. You got to be a little nuts. Like some of the best old linemen are a little crazy. And I think that's a little bit what it is. You know, you got to have a little insanity in you to, you know, do a job that, you know, it's weird. O-line's like probably the only position that like doesn't need help from anybody else. You know, a quarterback needs an O-line to block for him, needs receivers to get open, receivers need to like O-line. It's just us. Right. We're on an island. We're just doing we don't need anybody else. It's just us. And we get no love, no gratitude. And all we're doing is just protecting people
right. And
hurting people. And that's all we care about. So, right. I mean, you got to be a little crazy. And I think you need a little bit of that in there too.
Mm-hmm. Listen, 100%. I want to get you crunk, but it ain't enough room in here for me and you. So we're going to keep it copacetic. We're going to keep it calm. You got time for one more segment. You got to get out of here.
I got to get out of here. I got to get to my day job working out.
Come on. Hey, you tell the people, you can say what you want. You can talk about the jerky. Just let the people out there know about Cam Jurgens and tell them how appreciative you are just for us to have fans like we got. Mm-hmm. The best fans in the country.
Yeah, I mean, I appreciate you having me on here. I appreciate all the Husker fans out there. Y'all are the best. I'll be a Cornhusker for life. You guys are the best. And, I mean, just go Big Red. Let's go. I'm so excited for Matt Rhule and the coaches and the players that are in that building. So that's what I'm excited for. So I'm going to shout out them players. They're gonna have a good year this year.
Come on, man. Cam Jurgens, 93.7 a ticket. Appreciate you, big fella.
Yes, sir. Throw it.
Are you working in or looking to get into the electrical construction industry? The electrical workers of Local Union 265 are now hiring licensed journeymen and apprentices and are offering great pay and benefits. Call Mike at 402-875-1034 to apply. Start your electrical career today.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather, sponsored by John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
The Lincoln forecast for today, we'll see mainly sunny skies to go along with mild temperatures. It's an afternoon high around 68. Tonight, partly cloudy skies expected with an overnight low around 44. And tomorrow, we'll see partly sunny skies and more mild temperatures with an afternoon high again around 68. I'm meteorologist Kyle Fletcher for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Ever wish you had another light switch on the other side of the room on a dark night? How much better would you sleep at night if you had a ceiling fan in your room? The High Electric Service Department is here to make your electrical what-ifs a reality. Whether you're looking to replace some outdated light fixtures or brighten up your counters with under-cabinet lighting, High Electric can handle all types of residential electrical installations and services. Give Erica a call at 402-466-6606 or visit high-electric.com to get started.
For over 15 years, Integrated Life Choices has empowered individuals with disabilities in Lincoln and throughout Nebraska. They provide comprehensive services from group homes and independent living services to job training, ensuring fulfilling lives for those that they serve. Now, they're inviting you to join their mission. If you're passionate about making a difference in the lives of people with developmental disabilities, explore rewarding career opportunities with them. Learn more about their services and apply today at www.ilc.net. Be a part of Integrated Life Choices, where your work truly changes lives.
Rosie Sports Bar and Grill, open for lunch and dinner at 1501 Center Park Road.
This is Monster Jam. Witness big air, two-wheel skills, backflips, and all-out racing. Monster Jam, as big as it gets. Brought to you by the original super glue. Stop by your local participating Westlake Ace Hardware locations for your $10 savings coupon. Restrictions may apply. See store for details. Coming to Pinnacle Bank Arena this Friday and Saturday.
Get rid of pesky critters once and for all with Bats to Rats. Their expert team is here to help you reclaim your home. No more sleepless nights caused by crawling critters or flapping wings. Bats to Rats ensures a safe environment for every family member. Check the website at batstorats.com for amazing offers. And if you mention this ad, you'll receive $10 off your initial inspection cost. Call Bats to Rats today at 402-781-8691. That's 402-781-8691. Bats to Rats.
The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Thursday, March 28th versus the Grand Rapids Rise at CHI Health Center in Omaha. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 6 p.m. with first serve at 7. Make sure to tune in to the next Ag Appraisal Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas radio network.
Start your Sundays off right with Jeff and Nicole Essink on Fitness Fanatics. Jeff and Nicole discuss health and wellness, how to achieve fitness goals, and more through the life of gym owners and gym goers. It's Fitness Fanatics from 9 to 11 a.m. on Sundays on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Okay, it's time to sell the house. How do we even begin to choose from the hundreds of realtors in town?
Easy, we make a pros list.
You mean a pros and cons list?
No, just a pros list. We need someone with pro photography to showcase the house in the best possible way, pro marketing to make sure we get maximum exposure, pro negotiations so we know we get the best price.
This is one of those times where you already know the right answer, isn't it?
You know it is. Ben Bleicher and Professional Realty Group.
Contact Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Services Ambassador online at prg-ne.com.
Plains Cover Crop is your one-stop seed shop. Call us now for spring and summer forages, CRP mixes, and fall cover crop blends. We do farm-specific consulting for practical and efficient seed blends to fit your geography and goals. With a very diverse inventory, we will tailor a blend just for you. We're also looking for contract growers, and we buy and sell rye. Find us online at plainscovercrop.com. Timeless agronomy practices paired with modern technology. East Highway 20 in Orchard and across Nebraska.
Spring is here. It's time to get back outside and into proper shoes this year. Brown Shoe Fit is the place to buy this spring with their sale on athletic shoes. Get $15 off any regular price athletic shoes with respected brands like Hoka, Brooks, New Balance, and On Running. And don't forget, Brown's carries a large arrangement of sizes and widths to fit your feet properly. Start your spring off right at Brown Shoe Fit, just south of 66 and Q in Lincoln.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Back in studio with you here on 93.7 The Ticket. This is the captain, and we just had Cam Jurgens. Yes, that Cam Jurgens. I don't know if there are too many other Cam Jurgens, but Philadelphia Eagles Cam Jurgens, former Husker, in studio. That was a lot of fun, and man, seriously, his jerky is delicious. I was just telling him, you know, we've all got our different preferences, I'm sure, for jerky, but I just like love the texture of it. It's not too chewy, but it's not too hard. I kind of like a more chewy bacon and or chewy jerky, and that is just great stuff. So try that if you haven't tried it. I know it's been around for a while. We all know about the jerky wars as well going on here at the University of Nebraska. I'm on team jerky.co again. Jerky.co is where you go to get that.
You said the jerky wars.
Yeah, you didn't. You were a little bit. You didn't hear about the jerky wars, huh?
No. Why? Who cares about jerky wars?
Well, Cam Jurgens probably
Who is trying to compete with the jerky beef jerky? No one can compete with the beef jerky from Jerky.
That's what I would say.
So what are you talking about? Who's trying to do that?
I think I'd have to look it up. I think there's a few other places that are trying to capitalize basically on
pipeline jerky
of Cam's idea.
Oh, well, I don't know. You got to have the right jerky, though. I think this here, that's what I was telling Cam off air. It's good. I like beef jerky, but I don't like hard beef jerky. It's got to be just right.
Yeah.
Like you said, texture. Anywho, I hope you guys enjoyed that. Let's go to the text line. I hope you guys enjoyed Cam coming in and sharing his time, his life. He's got just so many different stories, and I've watched the kid since he was a kid, and I watched him grow into the man that he is today. And so just to have him come on, we're going to try to make sure that we get a plethora of guys on, especially the guys that grace us with their presence. I talked to Jackson, the military Jackson.
Okay,
and,
yeah.
And I'm hope to have him on next week. He's back. He's in the CFL. So I hope to have him on. And just talk a little bit about some military stuff, talk a little bit about, because I know he did finally retire. So just have some great conversations with these guys as they're winding their careers down in the NFL or heating them up. But I think sometimes we should always want to hear from the guys that we cheer from, you know. And I don't know how many people heard from Cam before, but I know for me to talk to Cam, to talk to him in the weight room, to see his heart, his mentality is an honor for me. So Cam, keep doing what you're doing. Philly is my team, y'all. Philly is my team. I'm running with Philly.
Now. Okay.
It is now. Yeah, yeah. I'm a super fan weather fan when it comes to NFL.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they do nothing.
But you mentioned Devin Weiss there now. What kind of led to that? I mean, obviously he was in Tampa for a long time.
I think, you know, sometimes you wear out your welcome. And I'm not going to say he wore his welcome out, but I think he might have wore his welcome out.
Yeah.
I think at the end of the day, you know, he went there as a rookie. You know, I don't think that they were willing to give him a long-term contract, a big one. So, you know, signing this one-year tenure at Philly, I mean, it's worth $7 million. That's a lot of money, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a good
deal. I mean, to have a one-year tenure worth $7 million and to have an opportunity for all the teams to sign you now, he's got to have a good year. I'm going to tell you right now, bet green. If you bet green, you want to bet with me, Bob?
I don't know what bet green means, but
that means if me and you take Philly now, what's text lines open? Help us out, 402-464-5685. What's the odds of Philly winning the Super Bowl if you pick them now? I'm just curious what those odds would look like.
Mm.
Anything on, let's go to the text line. Quite sure. And again, guys, sometimes I like to take questions from the text line when we got guests, but I knew he only had a couple of segments, so I didn't want to, you know, we want Cam to come back. We want Cam to feel like he is a part of the ticket. So we want to respect his time, and I just wanted to do that. Respect his time. Make sure that he comes back and graces with his presence again.
Byron the Hog Farmer doesn't believe in the Eagles. He says, not winning, Vershawn. They're losing older players and coach on the hot seat. You remember about what was that, week 12 or 13, whatever it was, they were the best team in the league last year and then kind of have a losing streak. So we'll see. Sirianni definitely took some heat there at the end, but they are, a year and a half removed from being in the Super Bowl? So can't be too bad.
Didn't they go to the playoffs?
They did. They actually lost to the Buccaneers in the wild card game.
Oh, okay.
But it was part of, I have to go back and look. It was like a 5-game losing streak or something like that to end the year.
Yeah, but you got to think they're adding some nice pieces. They're getting Saquon Barkley. They're adding some nice pieces. And I mean, you can say what you want. They got one of the best quarterbacks in the league.
Yeah.
That in itself is going to put them back into the playoffs. So I look for them to do. I'm a Fairweather fan, man. I'm going with my family and then with Cam.
Yeah.
Cam, give me free beef jerky.
Well, too, I mean, I'm interested to see. I mean, the Eagles run that 4th-and-1 or 3rd-and-1 quarterback sneak. And Cam's now, you know, he already was a part of it, obviously, at the guard position, a big part of the center of that line. But, you know, being the center, that's he definitely got to win that battle on that play.
Well, you better win that battle on that play. I mean, you got to think he's got to compete, though, with I think they went and got a Matt Hennessy. Hennessy's a veteran. I want to say 10, 12-year veteran. So I know they went and got Matt Hennessy. I don't want to call it out of the transfer portal. But I know they did. So, you know, Cam's going to have to work his butt off to be the guy. I believe he's got – the thing I love about Cam is he doesn't let the money or the fame get to him. He's still the same dude. Working out. He got shorts on. He ain't flamboyant. None of that. So, I like that. When guys – when they have that mentality, they play a long time. Anyway.
Notorious B.I.B. says, great interview with Cam, guys. Downtown – Scott says, nice shirt, VJ. He likes your shirt.
Yeah, we would. It's true.
That's what he would have destroyed Michigan in 97 if you're in the radio. PCAT wonders if Cam ever thought about what it would have been if he stayed at tight end instead of moving to center. I'm sure that thought process crosses his mind here and there.
He would have been at home right now trying to figure out what time he was going to work.
I don't know about that. Please. I don't know about that.
Cam would not be playing. He wouldn't have been the second pick, the 51st pick overall.
As a tight end?
No way. 6'3"? No way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, he would have had to, his body would have been shaped differently for the last 5 or 6 years. But yeah, you're right. I mean, it would have been different.
Cam put himself in the best position possible by going from center, tight end. To center, I think he put himself in. He couldn't have asked for a better story, a better situation. So I think Cam did great for himself. I don't think Cam would change anything about the tight end spot. I think playing center, look at the offensive linemen as a whole. Who plays longer, running backs or offensive linemen?
Oh, linemen generally.
Receivers or offensive linemen?
You got some older offensive linemen.
Yeah. Quarterbacks or offensive linemen?
Now, there are sometimes quarterbacks can play, but usually still there's one position compared to five.
Mm-hmm. Just saying. Guys, I'm putting raw sugar in here, by the way. I know you guys are watching me make my coffee, but I need a little coffee at the Cam Jurgens, man. I need a pick-me-upper.
Yeah.
Yeah, because right now I'm a little somber because I was like, I really wanted to get hype up in here with Cam, and I got to thinking, me and Cam getting hype together inside the studio is probably not a smart move. It'd be too much stuff going on up in here. But I'm serious, though. The way Cam plays, you know, tell me what guy off the offensive line last year played like Cam.
Oh, they don't have it. They didn't have a Cam.
No. Right. I mean, you had a Ben Scott. Ben Scott got after it.
Yeah. Well, and that's too. I mean, I know you were asking him, you know, about how Nebraska gets five Cam Jurgens. I mean, that's tough. That's tough to ask because you mentioned it. He's a second round draft pick. So, I mean, Nebraska's just. Feels so far away from that, but
you win championships.
Yeah, I mean, that's right. That's those Cam Jurgens. Those are the types of guys you need. You can't, you know, and you don't want to like belittle or say like, you know, anything derogatory, but it's like he was very special in that locker room from the minute he stepped on. And you could tell with him and Cam Taylor Britt, who both became second round picks, their athleticism was just separated. And you just need a few more of those guys, basically, is the thing.
You need a lot more of those guys.
I'm trying to be nice. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't be nice right now, Bach. Listen, Bach, we ain't being nice no more.
Yeah.
Oh, listen, when Trev left, all that nice went out the door. Okay. New athletic director, Troy Dannon, told you if it's not helping football win games, we ain't doing it. Now. I like that. I do. Yeah. I like that mentality. Why would we do something that's not going to help us, not going to help the student athletes win games?
It's a good thing to say. It gets people going.
Well, do you believe?
Like I said, I'm probably at the point of this is my I made the confession yesterday. This is like your a mom dating the sixth guy after your dad. You know, it's kind of like here's the sixth AD since Nebraska's been right, and he says the right things too. And I, you know, he's
no
a nice
AD has spoke like him.
Yeah.
No. We had Trev. Trev sold us the dream.
They've all got different things, right? But it's all, you know. There's nothing that you can say that you just come in and all of a sudden I'm just 100% believe this is going to be great and you'll be your AD for the next 20 years. But I don't know if he's that kind of hire. Maybe it will work out that way. You never know. And so I'm, it's not that I don't believe in him. I want to see it. I want to see what happens here, but I would be lying, just straight lying to you if I didn't also say there are a few things that are like, okay, well, we'll see. I mean, the biggest thing to me is 6 months at Washington. And he said coming to Nebraska was just a big part of leaving Washington. It's like, okay, but you know, you better hope Nebraska's his A1 job then, because if somebody else comes calling, he might leave you. And then the other thing, I again, you disagreed, but I think firing a coach and then just leaving as the athletic director with an open spot's a little bit strange. It's not something that I would see done so often. So it's not a bad deal. It's just one of those things of like, hey, going back to my relationship thing, is if be careful of how you get into a relationship, because it might be the same way that you get out of that relationship.
What's your dream job?
Right here. Your spot, actually.
Stop it. What's your dream job? Seriously. Do you have a dream job?
I don't know if I necessarily have a dream job.
Really?
Yeah. I mean,
like if you could be doing anything in the world and be making $1 million doing it, what would you do? Boy, it's taking you a long time to think about that.
Probably this. That's why I've been here for so long. I really enjoyed, you know, being on radio covering Husker sports. This is, you know, like you said, the pay maybe would go up a little bit for my dream job, but yeah.
They just made you the general.
$2 million.
You're the general manager of 93.7, the ticket. We're going to pay you $250,000 a year. Explain to me what it would take for you to leave.
$300,000 here.
No, where though? Not here.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Nobody's going to give it to you here.
Yeah.
I'm saying, but let's say you had to move to Baton Rouge, Louisiana to make $275,000. Would you do it?
Yeah. I mean, like right now, yeah, that'd be good.
No, I'm saying you're making $250 though.
Yeah.
You're making $250 okay, and you're the GM here. Would you go to another spot, be the GM there for $275,000? And a horrible situation.
No.
Exactly. That's my point. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to run, know when to walk away. Trev walked away, I thought prematurely, but we'll see. Only time will tell. I think when the smoke clears and things start coming out, it might get a little bit different for Mr. Trev Alberts. You can throw it to break.
All right, you're listening to the captain here on 93.7 The Ticket with three-time national champ Rashawn Jackson, All-American, and oh wait, no, Terrell's not here, and myself, Jake Bachman. We'll be back after this.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
Start your Sundays off right with Jeff and Nicole Essink on Fitness Fanatics. Jeff and Nicole discuss health and wellness, how to achieve fitness goals, and more through the life of gym owners and gym goers. It's Fitness Fanatics from 9 to 11 a.m. on Sundays on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Sandhills Global is hiring. With their fast-paced, growing culture, they have hundreds of new openings in sales, marketing, traveling support, software development, web design, and more. Full-time roles offer a 4.5-day work week, along with flexible internships in most areas. Career and internship opportunities are available at our global headquarters in Lincoln, Nebraska. Find your fit today at www.sandhills.jobs.
Spring is here. It's time to get back outside and into proper shoes this year. Brown Shoe Fit is the place to buy this spring with their sale on athletic shoes. Get $15 off any regular price athletic shoes with respected brands like Hoka, Brooks, New Balance, and On Running. And don't forget, Brown's carries a large arrangement of sizes and widths to fit your feet properly. Start your spring off right at Brown Shoe Fit, just south of 66 and Q in Lincoln.
Ever wish you had another light switch on the other side of the room on a dark night? How much better would you sleep at night if you had a ceiling fan in your room? The High Electric Service Department is here to make your electrical what-ifs a reality. Whether you're looking to replace some outdated light fixtures or brighten up your counters with under-cabinet lighting, High Electric can handle all types of residential electrical installations and services. Give Erica a call at 402-466-6606 or visit high-electric.com to get started.
Spring often marks the beginning of severe weather, which can lead to power outages. LES wants you to be prepared before the storm. Restock your emergency kit, update your info with LES, and if you encounter an outage, report it at les.com/report.
This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Touchdown! Vershawn Jackson, number 34. Gets the touchdown.
Terrell Farley. Defending Terrell Farley,
who last week in his first start was a holy terror. Number 43.
And Jake Bakoven.
I've talked a few cats. They said that Bak got some game, man.
Coming at you live from the Copple Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Powered by Bauer. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
There it is. Nice little turkey sandwich. Is the round of eight set left yet?
Sweet 16 kicks off tonight.
Sweet 16, UConn, San Diego State, yeah. Illinois, Iowa State, North Carolina, Alabama, Clemson, Arizona, shocker, Houston, Duke, NC State versus Marquette, Purdue versus Gonzaga, Creighton versus Tennessee. Just give me a little heads up. I need to go to the computer hardware store. I need to go see Jeremiah Tripp. He was on the morning show. And I need Jeremiah Tripp. If you're listening to Jeremiah Tripp, I'm coming to see you when I get off work, but I'm going to get some computers handled.
You know, of those games, by the way, I feel like I'm going to be staying up late because the late games are the most exciting to me. Illinois and Iowa State is the 9 o'clock game tonight. If you're trying to plan out your day, it's Clemson, Arizona at 6, San Diego State, UConn at 6:30, North Carolina, Alabama at 8:30. Latrell Wright Sell Jr. on that Alabama team.
Nice.
Iowa State, Illinois, obviously Big Ten affiliation there with Illinois. Iowa State, T.J. Otzelberger, a former Fred Hoiberg assistant. So lots to kind of dive into there.
You need to tell me that Creighton didn't pick up Latrell Wright Sell Jr.?
They were not able to. I don't know if they went after him. But
okay, good.
By the way, if you see, like, there's so many people hit the transfer portal, and it's crazy just to follow along. Nebraska's obviously had four guys themselves, but to follow along at home is, you know, it's fun on Twitter because you see, like, oh, this guy hit the transfer portal, and then, like, a day later, it's, like, 18 teams contacted him. And Nebraska's, you know, often a part of that, so... It's interesting to see just kind of how that works. As soon as the season over, man, do you have to flip that switch going into next season and building beyond? But to my other point, though, tomorrow night, 9 o'clock game is Creighton in Tennessee. And of course, that's got a lot of local flavor and interest to it. Purdue and Gonzaga, of course, the Big Ten connection there at 6:30 tomorrow night. Marquette, North Carolina State at 6 and Duke and Houston at 8:30.
My sleeper. Blue Jays, baby. Blue Jays.
Yeah, yeah.
You can't say nothing to me about being a Jaysker if they go to the Final Four. Shut up about me being a Jaysker. Just shut up.
Still tell you you're a Jaysker.
You can't.
What?
Yeah, it's a good thing. You can't try to make it derogatory or like it's a problem because I'm a Jaysker.
It'll be a problem.
It's not a problem. Until Nebraska actually wins a game in the tournament, it's not a problem. We haven't won a game at the University of Nebraska in the tournament.
Well, to what you were just saying, maybe about Wright Sell, neither of them landed him. Alabama did, but
I thought there was something where he transferred to Alabama. I thought
he did. Yeah, he transferred there.
Well, Creighton had an opportunity. Trust me, I know his dad. He had an opportunity.
I'm just saying it is that you, as much as you say, okay, if Nebraska
had an opportunity
playing,
to get,
I know,
the kid,
I know, but
why didn't we get him? He's from here. Omaha, Nebraska. His dad, I know why they didn't get him, because it is bullcrap Jaysker stuff. The same reason why we didn't get Pyfrom. Because it's Jasker stuff.
I don't know.
I'm telling you, it's the Jasker stuff.
What's that mean? How does Jasker factor into it?
Well, why would there's nobody from Nebraska that played for Creighton? Like his dad played for Creighton. Okay?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Creighton fathers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nebraska, you mean to tell me that you're going to let him go to Alabama? Alabama's in the Sweet 16. You're not even in anything. But this same kid, what year is this for him, a junior?
Let me double check.
His dad said to me, and I quote, Nebraska said that basically he wasn't good enough. So, now you tell me. You tell me.
I mean, he's not necessarily starring for Alabama, but he's doing fine.
Well, give me his stats.
For what it's worth, he was at Cal State Fullerton his first 3 years. This is his senior year. And he averaged 16 his last year at Cal State Fullerton. He averages 9. 9 points, 3 rebounds. See on the shooting, 44% from deep. That could help. And 44% overall.
Huh.
But he's a flamethrower. So he takes 6.6 shots per game. 5 of those are 3-point shots. So
that's the guy.
He's a sharpshooter.
A sharpshooter.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, you get an opportunity to get a guy that's in Nebraska, all of a sudden you're going to act like Creighton is in Uganda or something? No. Creighton, Omaha is in Nebraska. It's in Nebraska.
Mm-hmm. I don't blame Omaha folks for, especially like right now, if you're a kid growing up in Omaha, you can go watch those Creighton games and you're seeing a team that's maybe going to the Elite Eight in consecutive years or who knows where this thing ends. Regardless, Elite Eight, Sweet 16, relevant, top 15 team all year long. I don't blame you if you start cheering for Creighton a little bit. But I'm in the minority. I don't speak for the most of Husker Nation who says you got to pick a side because we don't want you coming around in the football season and covering your Creighton gear with
Creighton.
Your
Creighton don't have a football team.
Well, don't join our team if you don't join. And if you don't
from
like
what
the
I hear, when
program.
Creighton did have a football team, they beat Nebraska.
What year was that?
It was a long time ago before the war, and they said the reason why they discontinued football, text line is open, you guys know about this, is because a lot of the players went to the war.
Mm.
Yeah. I'm still a Jasker. I love Husker basketball, and I love Jasker basketball. Husker and Jasker.
And Jasker.
Yeah, Jasker, not Blue Jay.
No.
No, Jasker basketball. I love it. I do. I really do. I love it when they come together and play each other. And, you know, I'm just simply saying, man, don't be hating, man. Don't hate on the Jays. Don't hate on the Jays, bro. You can't tell me you ain't got a Lincoln College that you can get excited about, can you?
For basketball, Nebraska basketball has had one of their best seasons they've ever had.
I'm talking
this
now.
Past
I'm, talk,
year.
I'm talking right now, though. I'm
not, yeah, in the about, tournament? No.
I ain't talking about just making it to the tournament. We made it to the Big Ten tournament. Did we win?
No.
Perfect.
You make the Big Ten tournament regardless.
Exactly. But I'm saying we didn't win. We lost.
Yeah.
And then we took that idea and mentality into the big tournament.
Yeah.
And we got crashed.
That happens to half the teams that make the tournament.
Well.
It's tough to win in March.
Ask Oakland.
Yeah.
Oakland won.
Yeah, Oakland won.
Well.
Nebraska
don't act
do
like
it.
It's not doable.
No,
it's doable.
It's doable. But I don't know. I speak from a weird angle of, like, I appreciate Creighton. I love them in the Big East. I've worked plenty of their games. I've been to a few of their games. So I kind of appreciate Creighton. But so I can cheer for them. I cheer for them in March. I just
well,
hide
you're
that.
A Jasker.
I hide that fact.
Oh,
yeah.
So you're a Jasker.
I'm a Jasker, too, yeah.
Give me something, Bob. Make sure you tell. Listen. A lot of
but
stuff.
I'm knowledgeable that it's not right to be one.
A lot. What do you mean it ain't right?
Well, especially for me. I don't live in Omaha or anything. I think if you're in Omaha, you get a pass.
Okay.
You get
I got
the
you.
Pass. Yeah.
I got you.
But if you're in Lincoln, you probably shouldn't like Creighton at all. But I do. I kind of like
them. Oh, that's not right. You guys can like them anyway.
I feel bad no, about it. Not, I don't I, want look, to
she's
like
She's looking like, we're on this side. We're on this side now. She was looking because she was on the other side and took the picture with me and Cam. And then she just looked like, hey, how did they get over there?
Wait a minute.
Yeah, no, we got two windows. We got a window on that side and a window on the other side. What's the text line saying?
1841 says that's like Trev saying he's still a Husker. You're either with us or against us.
Who said that?
1841.
That's not true. You can't say that. No. Trev's athletic director. He can't. He cannot. If I was the athletic director, then I would not be able to say I'm a J-Scare anymore. Yeah, it's over with.
Yeah, I know.
Because I work for the university. Yeah, I work for the university, okay? But I'm a fan. So I can do that. So you can't try to put Trev and then Trev committed treason.
I'm telling you, people have some feel. We got them in their feelings now. Down,
Trev
down,
committed treason.
Down Scott says, bleep Creighton, no pass. So you don't get a pass. Corey Lincoln says, Creighton fans are bleeps. Anyone that's been to a Creighton Nebraska games at PBA knows that.
They're what? They're what? They're
well,
what?
I can't say that on
Let me
air.
See what he said. Oh.
Yeah, I can't say that.
I don't believe not all of them.
Not all of them.
But there's some Husker fans that's that too.
Yeah, that's true.
Dang, so that's anybody.
5475 says boo Jaskers. 83789, no pass VJ, bleep Creighton. 0601 that's turned on the show. Might as well call this the Jasker show.
Don't be hating, man. This is Lincoln. Listen. 93.7 The Ticket, theticketfm.com, Lincoln's Real Sports Talk. I don't see where it says Husker Real Sports Talk. Where is that at?
No, it's
is, it a, is, this a, is this a Husker?
It's not exclusive.
Is this a Husker Sports Talk radio show?
No, I don't see a whole lot of former Creighton players walking around.
That's only because most of the Creighton former players, they go on their lawyers. They got money.
Us
little peons, we got to come back.
Little Nebraska guys.
Yeah, we got to get some NIL money, man. Thank you, DP, for getting us a couple quarters. I mean, it's better than nothing, right?
7563, by the way, says, I hope Nebraska goes after William Kyle from South Dakota State. That would be an interesting one. And I know they have contacted him, or at least according to, again, what I was saying earlier on Twitter, where you see who's contacted who. But he's interesting in that he did not take a three-point last year, a three-point shot. And Nebraska, of course, had their most success with a five-out type of offense. And Blaze Cada transferred. I mean, he kind of would fit in that realm of not being able to stretch it. So I'm interested to see. And you kind of change with what you can get. But Kyle would be an interesting addition for Nebraska. If
who
they can get him.
Is the top 10 kids in the country in basketball?
Most of them are going to Duke and Rutgers, of all places.
I'm going to say this one more time. Whoever the top 10, 15, 20 guys is, and that's who we need to be focused on, because your athletic director said, we're going to spend some money. We're going to get the guys that we got to get into our university. Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you? Bach, you the athletic director. Don't you go out and you going to recruit the number 200 player in the country? Oh, because you feel like, oh, he don't want to play for us. He might go to the Jays. Come on, man. Come on, 1890. Come on, Matt Davidson. Ha! Shake him up, shake him up, shake him up, shake him. Come on, Matt Davidson. We need the number 1 to 20 recruit in the country in basketball. And then I'll become a... I can't even say it. It's too crazy. I was trying to figure out how you can be a Husker J, but you can't be a Husker J. You got to be a J-Sker.
Yeah, you're still a J-Sker.
You're a J-Sker. I embrace my J-Skerism. Okay? I'm not mad about that at all.
Yeah,
and some of my best friends are basketball players that play for the Huskers. And I love the Huskers. Head to head, I'm taking Nebraska. Unless it's this year, I'm taking Creighton. How about your boy, dog? We always up to no good over here on 93.7 The Ticket, fastest 2 hours in racing. Yeah, you good, you good, you good. From Hollywood to South
Central. Ever wish you had another light switch on the other side of the room on a dark night? How much better would you sleep at night if you had a ceiling fan in your room? The High Electric Service Department is here to make your electrical what-ifs a reality. Whether you're looking to replace some outdated light fixtures or brighten up your counters with under-cabinet lighting, High Electric can handle all types of residential electrical installations and services. Give Erica a call at 402-466-6606 or visit high-electric.com to get started.
Hi, folks. Sean Callahan here for Koppel Chevrolet GMC, and the Chevrolet and GMC Truck Month is now underway. We've got huge savings in Louisville. Get $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months on select models. Yes, you heard right. That's $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months happening right now at Koppel. So take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at koppelcars.com. You'll be glad you did. All deals with proof credit. Stock number G214773.
Plains Cover Crop is your one-stop seed shop. Call us now for spring and summer forages, CRP mixes, and fall cover crop blends. We do farm-specific consulting for practical and efficient seed blends to fit your geography and goals. With a very diverse inventory, we will tailor a blend just for you. We're also looking for contract growers, and we buy and sell rye. Find us online at plainscovercrop.com. Timeless agronomy practices paired with modern technology. East Highway 20 in Orchard and across Nebraska.
How do people feel about getting Big Fitness Energy at Planet Fitness for $1 down and $10 a month? They feel as thrilled as a kid the first summer they're tall enough to ride the roller coaster! That's right. When you join Planet Fitness right now, you'll get access to tons of equipment and free fitness training in a clean and spacious club. Don't wait. Join the judgment-free zone today for that all-day energy. Download the free Planet Fitness app and join today for $1 down, $10 a month.
Deal in soon.
See Home Club for details.
Spring is here. It's time to get back outside and into proper shoes this year. Brown Shoe Fit is the place to buy this spring with their sale on athletic shoes. Get $15 off any regular price athletic shoes with respected brands like Hoka, Brooks, New Balance, and On Running. And don't forget, Brown's carries a large arrangement of sizes and widths to fit your feet properly. Start your spring off right at Brown Shoe Fit, just south of 66th and Q in Lincoln. At Parkview Animal Hospital in Lincoln, it's not just the professional care that sets them apart, but their warm staff and state-of-the-art facilities. Whether it's for a routine checkup or a comprehensive medical procedure, at Parkview, your pet isn't just another number, but a valued member of their caring family. Visit them at pahlincoln.com today and in person just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road. Parkview Animal Hospital, your pet, our passion. For happier, healthier furry friends.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
The Lincoln forecast for today, we'll see mainly sunny skies to go along with mild temperatures. See an afternoon high around 68. Tonight, partly cloudy skies expected with an overnight low around 44. And tomorrow, we'll see partly sunny skies and more mild temperatures with an afternoon high again around 68. I'm meteorologist Kyle Klecker for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Shopping for new flooring is different today. Getting your questions answered, making the right selection, getting the best value, and install quickly and professionally. Visit ostreetcarpet.com or shop our store. We'll answer all your questions and help you make the right choice. You'll be enjoying your new floor in just days for less than you'd pay elsewhere. Carpet, vinyl, wood, laminate, tile, and area rugs. We've got it all. Old Street Carpet. 1732 O Street. Family owned and operated. Always the best value.
Working at Continental in Lincoln isn't a job. It's a career. And right now, they've raised wages again, and they're hiring for production operators at $24.62 per hour, which grows to $28.97 per hour within 3 years. Skilled trade positions now start at $33.36 per hour, with opportunities to make more based on certifications. Continental also has salary jobs available and great benefits, plus medical and prescription costs at very low premiums. Dental, vision, and life insurance are offered at no premium cost to the associates, with increased bonuses and vacation for new hires. To learn more or apply, go to continentaljobs.com with keyword Lincoln. Come work at Continental today.
Cover more acres with a pre-owned sprayer or planter from Landmark Implement, your local John Deere dealer. We offer one of the area's largest selections of used sprayers, applicators, planters, and seeders. Through the month of March, take advantage of fixed-rate financing as low as 3.9% for up to 60 months or a 12-month interest waiver. Visit your local Landmark Implement location or view our complete sprayer and seeding inventory online at landmarkimp.com and experience the Landmark difference.
Action Plumbing, Heating, Air, and Electric is the call I make when I have a need for plumbing services. Whether it's for my home or office, if I need a repair to a water heater, softener, or even my garbage disposal, I know I can count on Action to help. In one simple call, their amazing customer service team promptly schedules a service call, often getting to my needs within a day. Action delivers honest, quality services we can count on. To learn more, visit actionlincoln.com.
A team succeeds when they work together. Banking's no different. At UBT, we're in your corner for every financial move you want to make. Your money's backed by a roster of experts who put in the work to know you and your community. So whether you're opening a savings account, buying a home, or planning your future, you always know who to turn to. Working together toward your financial goals, that's a win in our playbook. Union Bank and Trust, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Constructors is now hiring for all positions, with laborers starting at $23 and up based on experience. Constructors has immediate job openings for laborers, mechanics, bridge builders, operators, and drivers. Start your new career today. Constructors offers great pay, health, dental, and vision insurance, paid time off, paid holidays, and so much more. Join the crew today and be a part of Nebraska's oldest paving company dating back to 1908. For a complete list of openings and to apply online, visit constructorslincoln.com.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Can't just have one. You gotta have multiple. Can't have just one. I just told you that. Can't have just one Cam Jurgens.
Yeah.
You gotta have multiple. You gotta have multiple guys that play like Cam Jurgens in order to be good. You gotta have more than just Eric Strickland. You gotta have Jerron Boone. You gotta have more than Jerron Boone. You gotta have Eric Piekowski. You gotta have more than Eric Piekowski. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You gotta have dudes in the room. You gotta get Terrence Padgett. You got to get John Wall. You got to get all these other basketball players, Larry Florence, Vincent Hamilton, Mikey Moore. I said Piekowski. It's another one. Kowski. His daughter plays. What's his name?
Markowski. Yeah.
Markowski. Jamar Johnson. Cookie Belcher. I can go on and on and on and on. You can't just get one guy. And there is no more Michael Jordans that can take a mediocre team. Even Michael Jordan couldn't take a Chicago team when they were right at the start of his career. He couldn't take them and go nowhere. They had to go get Scottie Pippen, the best Robin in the country. How dare you, Scottie, talk about you as better than Michael? It's like Robin telling Batman, come on, dog. This whole time I've been playing second fiddle to you, and I've been the real hero.
Well, if his wife starts dating Michael's son, then I might be telling him whatever I need to tell him, you know?
Whatever. Okay, come on, give us another one. We don't got a lot of time, so me and Bach just gonna go, so you know, we just playing right now.
So CJ Wilcher yesterday was the latest Husker men's basketball player to enter the transfer portal. Maybe you could see this coming. He did walk at senior night and all that, and seemed to be in his emotions and maybe feeling like that was the last time, but he's the first. There's four departures now from the basketball program. He's the first one that I would call, obviously that was in the rotation this last year. So I think these other ones, I think you would call healthy subtractions.
Ooh.
Blaise Cada was injured all year. Again, maybe didn't quite fit the offense that they had this year anyway. So it'd have been interesting if he wasn't. Ramel Lloyd Jr. never got playing time for whatever reason. Just feels like a healthy start there. Eli Rice, I mean, you could argue.
Hey, Lloyd getting up out of here?
Lloyd's gone, or at least in the transfer portal. Guys can come back from the transfer portal. Eli Rice played for a little bit and maybe, you know, had upside. I know people would maybe say that's not a healthy scratch from the roster, but it's, you know, it's a man that barely got any playing time leaving after 1 year. That happens everywhere in college basketball. CJ Wilcher is a guy that was kind of went through it. I mean, he's been through the down years with Fred Hoiberg, and he's been here for the rise and really came on his own as far as being able to mid-season. We were talking about maybe being the sixth man of the year in the Big Ten. Now he kind of got in a cold streak, wasn't hitting some of his threes down the stretch, but he was a big part and just fun and a weapon to kind of think about coming off the bench. He really has been coming into his own. His brother, of course, playing at St. John's. So maybe you look at something going that way. But it's sad to see CJ Wilcher go, as well as just obviously an excellent excellent member when he did come on here at 93.7 The Ticket. Was just, you know, very good at doing that as well. So it's tough to see CJ go. Not something, you know, as we kind of look at the top of the roster, and the biggest thing for Hoiberg is to be able to keep this thing together. I think one more big subtraction and you'd start to get worried, but right now you can kind of, okay, steady the waters.
CJ Wilcher. That's a tough one.
Yeah.
I thought CJ should have started, me personally. And CJ probably thought CJ should have started. But I can guarantee wherever he goes, he's going to start. It's not right to have CJ coming off the bench if he's better than a guy. I mean, who's he? Okay, who's the point guard?
They ended up with Bryce Williams basically running the point.
Who's the two? Tominaga?
Yeah, Tominaga.
Who's the three? That's where it gets foggy.
Yeah, I mean, Gary.
Is Gary better than CJ?
They have very different games, but yeah, I mean, I'd say he's more consistent, I suppose, in what he brings.
Okay, so this is his first year, right?
No, he's got the second year as a Husker.
That's what I'm talking about. Okay, yeah. but my point is CJ Wilcher's been here for four.
Yeah.
Okay, so like when you upset your team, I think sometimes that has an adverse effect, right? CJ Wilcher could have been really liked in that locker room.
I think he was.
Well, you don't think that this is going to have an effect?
I don't know how.
Unless
much
you
one.
Go get you some top 20 guys.
While I would not call it a healthy departure like these other ones would be called, is I think it is somewhat of a healthy departure because it still speaks to the competition to be able to play at Nebraska. When you look at who's coming back and returning without, you know, Tominaga and without Alec, you still got three year starters there. Lawrence, who was a part-time starter throughout the year, then kind of found his role off the bench in Hoiberg. You really don't want to have too much more than a nine-man rotation. So they just got a few spots to fill still to hopefully better the team going into next year. But, you know, the question now becomes what's the hardest thing to replace? And I still think you're in between Tominaga and Alex. So that's why I say like Wilcher hurt, like it hurts, but I wouldn't throw my hands up or think there's something wrong in the locker room. I just think, you know, maybe he felt like it was time to give it a go somewhere else. Maybe does want an expanded role, but part of that might be wanting the expanded roles. Because
what was Hoiberg's contract extension? Do you have that?
I'd have to pull it up.
No, pull that up real quick. I'm curious to know.
Yeah.
What that contract extension was. Anyway, I'll wait for you to give me that before I say my next deal. I get what you're saying. I think Nebraska is in a rebuild right now. We're in a real rebuild.
Basketball?
Yes. Tominaga's gone?
Yeah.
Who else is gone? You just said?
Alec.
Alec, number 13? What number?
53. He's number 53.
The big boy that can shoot? Number 53. One I like. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Perfect. He's gone.
Yeah.
That's a huge defender to be gone. CJ Wilcher's gone.
Mm-hmm.
You can say what you want about Romel, but I guarantee you he's going to be playing on somebody's team next year. He said no to a bunch of schools to come to Nebraska.
Yeah, it just didn't work out in Nebraska for what reason or the other. We don't
know.
Well,
he didn't play. That's why it didn't work out.
Well, right. But
I mean, dad moved all the way up here to watch his son play. And now dad's just up here.
I would say this is far from a rebuild, though. They have, what, six of their or five Ooh. Now of their
Who?
Eight-man rotation coming back?
Who?
Name them. Rick Mass. Juwan Gary.
Wait. Rick Mass is the center that shoot three.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'll give you one.
Juwan Gary.
And a half. No, I'm just playing. I'll give you two. I'm just playing. Give you two.
This is a full-time starter here.
All right, cool.
Bryce Williams. And again, all these guys, as of now, it's the transfer portal will still be open, but Bryce Williams.
Yeah.
Blake Lawrence.
Yeah.
And Hoiberg. Sam.
Okay. That ain't enough. I'm simply telling you, with those five guys, I love those five guys. They give us a great opportunity to win. That's not enough.
No, they'll have to add a few.
They're going to have to add more than a few. You almost got to have another five in order to compete. Do you think they're going to be better or worse if they don't get – you better get in the portal. You better get all over the place. If we don't get a couple of superstars in here, do you think we're going to get back to the dance?
No. That's what I'm saying. I don't know if you need superstars. You just need guys that, that kind of fit in, fit in a role.
Super. See, that's what I'm saying. You think superstars to me is a guy that's like a Michael Jordan. It's not. A superstar is a guy that will get after it when nobody is watching. He's the kind of guy that'll get after it on the defensive side of the ball. He's the type of guy that's going to make sure that every single time that the ball, a shot goes up, he boxes out. He's going to do the small things. That's the superstar to me. You can't find a game breaker. Who? Was Tominaga a game breaker to you?
He could be at times.
Like, you can't could be a game breaker. You either are or you're not.
Well, if you're a three-point shooter and you can hit 8 of 11 shots, then you're a game breaker that game. But if you have an off day and you go 2 of 7, then you're not a game breaker that game.
If anybody that watched Michael Jordan, how many times did Michael Jordan score less than 30 points?
Tominaga is not Michael Jordan.
That's a game breaker to me, Michael Jordan. That's why I just try to tell you.
Well, you got a very Tominaga's
not
that...
a game breaker. A game breaker shows up day in, day out.
Him and Rick Moss got all conference recognition. I think that's about as much as you could ask for, especially at a Nebraska program that generally doesn't have that.
I'm not taking anything from Tominaga. I think those guys are great players. What I'm trying to tell you is they're not game breakers. You can't put all your eggs in Tominaga's basket day in and day out, and he win for you. Sometimes he might have an offshoot night, right?
Yeah.
So that's all I'm saying. A guy that's a game breaker, he never has an offshoot night. If it is, it's rare. It's just rare. At least that's what I think. But what do I know about basketball? We better talk about football. Last segment coming up. Fastest 2 hours of radio. We'll be right back.
The Omaha Supernovas are back in action this Thursday, March 28th versus the Grand Rapids Rise at CHI Health Center in Omaha. The Mullen Motors pregame show with Derek Pearson and Renee Saunders starts at 6 p.m. with first serve at 7. Make sure to tune in to the next Ag Appraisal and Realty postgame show right after the match ends. Catch all the action on your flagship station, 93.7 The Ticket, and statewide on the Supernovas Radio Network.
Get rid of pesky critters once and for all with Bats to Rats. Their expert team is here to help you reclaim your home. No more sleepless nights caused by crawling critters or flapping wings. Bats to Rats ensures a safe environment for every family member. Check the website at batstorats.com for amazing offers. And if you mention this ad, you'll receive $10 off your initial inspection cost. Call Bats to Rats today at 402-781-8691. That's 402-781-8691. Bats to Rats.
How do people feel about getting big fitness energy at Planet Fitness for $1 down and $10 a month? They feel as thrilled as a kid the first summer they're tall enough to ride the roller coaster! That's right. When you join Planet Fitness right now, you'll get access to tons of equipment and free fitness training in a clean and spacious club. Don't wait. Join the judgment-free zone today for that all-day energy. Download the free Planet Fitness app and join today for $1 down, $10 a month.
Deal ends soon.
See Home Club for details.
Hi, folks. Sean Callahan here for Koppel Chevrolet GMC, and the Chevrolet and GMC Truck Month is now underway. We've got huge savings in Louisville. Get $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months on select models. Yes, you heard right. That's $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months happening right now at Koppel. So take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at koppelcars.com. You'll be glad you did. All deals with approved credit. Stock number G214773.
Hey, guys, it's Bill Bush. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty has opened a new location in Pender, Nebraska, in addition to their office in Lincoln. The real estate world can be confusing, so why wouldn't you want an expert helping you every step of the way? If you're looking to buy or sell farmland in Nebraska, Kansas, or Iowa, give Ethan Sorensen a call today at 402-380-0432 or visit them online at nextagrealestate.com. Next Ag Appraisal and Realty with locations in Lincoln and now Pender, Nebraska.
This is former Husker and NFL linebacker Jay Foreman. For years, I've suffered from degenerative problems in both of my ankles, but thanks to a thorough and thought-out plan provided by Advanced Medical Imaging, I was able to get my life back with the least amount of pain as possible. While working through multiple options, the team of physicians at Advanced Medical Imaging were there to answer any questions I had. If you're experiencing any pain at all and want to get your life back, go to amimaging.com or give them a call at 402-484-6677. Advanced Medical Imaging, located at 7601 Pioneer Boulevard.
Houses? They're expensive. And once you buy one, you're kind of stuck with it for a while. You need to make sure you get your best house for the best price. You need Ben Bleicher and his team of pros at Professional Realty Group. They'll take the time to figure out what's important for you in your dream home, and they have the expertise to find the hidden issues that could surprise you after the sale. That's professional knowledge, proactive service. We call that potential. Ben Bleicher and the team at Professional Realty Group of Berkshire Hathaway's Home Service Ambassador. Find more online at prg-ne.com.
Spring is a time of new beginnings and trying new things. If you haven't tried Fuhrer's Cheese Spread yet, the time is now. For parties for St. Patrick's Day and Easter, or celebrating the NCAA tournament with friends, there's no better dip to bring everyone together and celebrate something from Nebraska. Get to your local grocery store today and load up on Fuhrer's Cheese Spread. No event or party is complete without it on your table. Spring is here. It's time to get back outside and into proper shoes this year. Brown Shoe Fit is the place to buy this spring with their sale on athletic shoes. Get $15 off any regular price athletic shoes with respected brands like Hoka, Brooks, New Balance, and On Running. And don't forget, Brown's carries a large arrangement of sizes and widths to fit your feet properly. Start your spring off right at Brown Shoe Fit, just south of 66th and Q in Lincoln.
A team succeeds when they work together. Banking's no different. At UBT, we're in your corner for every financial move you want to make. Your money's backed by a roster of experts who put in the work to know you and your community. So whether you're opening a savings account, buying a home, or planning your future, you always know who to turn to. Working together toward your financial goals, that's a win in our playbook. Union Bank and Trust, Equal Housing Lender, Member FDIC.
Life is all about balance, so how about a little sweet and a little heat to make your week? At Wings and Rings, we're introducing our all-new Hot Honey menu for the month of March. Try our one-of-a-kind house-made sauce on the brand-new Hot Honey Chicken Sandwich or our Hot Honey Shrimp and Slaw. And of course, you can get it on the traditional boneless or smoked wings that have made Wings and Rings your go-to neighborhood spot. But don't wait, Hot Honey is only here until April 1st. So stop by Wings and Rings at one of our two Lincoln locations today, on O Street and on Village Lane.
Ironhide Construction is hiring. They're looking for hardworking, self-motivated individuals who are team players. Ironhide Construction has openings for an experienced project manager, estimator, apprentice, skilled laborer, and erector or installer. They will train the right people and make sure you understand the position and requirements. At Ironhide Construction, it's own it, be honest, and do it right. Apply today and learn more about their other benefits at ironhideconstruction.com. where they're committed to you every step of the way.
Shopping for new flooring is different today. Getting your questions answered, making the right selection, getting the best value, and installed quickly and professionally. Visit ostreetcarpet.com or shop our store. We'll answer all your questions and help you make the right choice. You'll be enjoying your new floor in just days for less than you'd pay elsewhere. Carpet, vinyl, wood, laminate, tile, and area rugs. We've got it all. Old Street Carpet. 1732 O Street. Family owned and operated. Always the best value.
Drinking and driving causes serious harm to friends, family members, and loved ones. In 2021, 65 people were killed in Nebraska by a car crash involving a drunk driver. Do not drink and drive. By drinking less, you can still be here for your loved ones. If you or a loved one is looking for help, find a treatment facility near you at findtreatment.gov. For immediate support, call, text, or chat 988.
Brought to you by Nebraska DHHS in partnership with SAMHSA.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, powered by Bauer, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
I'm going to sit down. I've been standing up the whole thing. Now I'm all of a sudden, I'm going to sit down because Nick comes in here. All of a sudden, I'm going to get humble and be like, oh, Nick.
That is not
I'm
true.
So happy to see you again, sir.
I'm good to see you too. I'm just so overwhelmed by the moments.
Tell me you miss me, Nick.
I'm not used to being on from 10 to noon, not being welcome. No, I'm just kidding.
We was on from 10 to 1. What are you talking about?
That's true.
Come on now.
No.
11 to 2? 11 to 2.
It was 11 to 2.
3 hours.
Yeah.
With me and Nick going ham.
2.5 too long.
Yeah, I don't know about that one. You know we was the best thing since Sipple.
I was just talking actually to somebody yesterday about remembering what it was supposed to be like at the start.
because I was in the meeting with who you were going to do the show with.
Right.
And then the first day it was like, nope, we're set switching up. It up.
The captains.
I got set up.
We're switching it up.
I got set up.
And Rashawn walked in and there I was just bright-eyed and bushy-tailed behind the board. I'll be your co-host, Rashawn. I'm Nick. There I was. Started a beautiful friendship.
And then before you know it, Nick was a big timer.
That is not true.
They didn't know Nick before. I watch your handle, buddy. All you got to do is go back to 2021.
My handle?
Yeah.
Your Twitter handle?
Your Twitter handle, sir.
Okay.
Your little handles you got out there.
Yep.
And I know what your handles. One. In 2021, I know where your handles were. I know what numbers you were at.
Where was
okay?
I at?
It wasn't that good. Okay? It was less than what the radio station was at, and they weren't that good.
Yep.
Exactly. I had more people than the radio station had when I came to the radio station.
Okay.
So what I will say, Nick, is I've watched you in 2 years become the guy that you are.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? And you've always been knowledgeable, which at your age, I was like, how do you know all of this? But you've studied.
We had some duels, Rashawn. I'm not going to lie.
We had some duels.
The one I remember the most is whether or not Adrian Martinez actually broke his jaw.
He didn't.
Well, I don't know. He didn't. I don't know about that.
I know he had his stuff wired shut, but you know what I'm saying? He still played. No, we were talking about that's what it was. We were talking about whether or not you could play with a broken jaw. You can't play football with a broken jaw.
You can, because Adrian Martinez did so.
He did not.
See, that's I don't know point. About that one.
All right, well, let's talk. Let's get current news. We ain't even gonna go back there. Me and you both was at practice. I left early because I had a show to do.
I left before you. I didn't see you there.
Oh, you didn't?
Because I rolled up. They let us in about 8:55, 9 o'clock.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And we were out of there about 9:20, 9:25.
Oh, so y'all just got to see him warm up. Good job.
No. So I will say, like, that's credit to this staff. They actually let us see some stuff.
Yeah.
Which is more than I can say about other staffs. Just because, like, and we know, like, we're not supposed to see. They don't want us seeing a ton of stuff, and I'm perfectly acceptable with that. Like, except I'm fine with that. At least, like, we're seeing drills when we go. In previous years, it's been like, all right, we're all gonna warm up. Yeah. And we're doing, you know, they got dudes doing high knees, and like, they're all, and you know, like, the warm-up periods, they take about 10 minutes. Well, you get 15. So you're like, all right, 10 minutes, and then you're doing a punting drill where it's, let's do special teams.
How do they tell you it's time for you guys to go?
Well, they just kind of wrestle. It's kind of like Keith will walk on down and be like, all right, guys, shots. And then we just slowly make our way down there.
Oh, Keith.
But Keith was good today. I like Keith a lot. Yeah. But no, it was good.
I've been knowing Keith a long time.
Yeah. I've only gotten yelled at once. I won't say who it was by. Not even yelled at. When I went down to practice last year, because I didn't realize that I was stepping on the white line.
Oh,
and you cannot.
That sounds
you
very cannot, famous to me.
You cannot step on the baseline. And I was watching. I think at this time I was watching. Whether I think it was like the DBs or something. And one of somebody comes to me, he's like, Nick, off the white line, off the white line, please, Nick, off the white line, please. And I was like, oh, sorry, so and so. I didn't even notice. I mean, we're talking like my toes were barely on it.
Yeah, I know, man.
I was like, all right, hey, but hey, you know what? Structure.
I get that part, but are we so big on structure that we forget it's football? You can be so worried about the guys standing in the peanut gallery that you're not worried about the guys that are
job.
Actually.
It wasn't a coach. It wasn't a coach.
I don't care.
It was their job.
I don't care.
It was their job to make sure.
They're to get back coach.
Not even coaches. It was their job
to get back player.
To say, hey, get on, you know, make sure get all back. The media is in the right spot.
Get back then, Nate.
They allowed it. I did. I apologized. And
It never happened again, right?
Nah.
All right. Well,
I kind of have an idea of where I can go now.
Where you know your limitations.
Where I'm allowed.
Talk about, I guess you didn't see much of practice. So,
I mean,
did you watch any of the quarterbacks throw the ball?
Who's gonna start in Nebraska? I ran outside. I ran outside a little bit. I will say, like, one thing I did notice, Marcus Satterfield was able to move a lot more freely in the period that we saw, just because he's not the quarterback's coach. Obviously, you know, he's labeled as the tight ends and offensive coordinator. So, like, today specifically for the portion that we saw, there wasn't a whole lot of tight end specific work going on. So he was able to move kind of freely throughout the offense, which is, I think, a benefit, right? Because we know and have heard that last year he was pretty tied with the quarterbacks, and you had to be, right? You have to be. And so Just being able to bring in a true quarterbacks coach now this year for the staff, I think is going to provide some benefits. I'm Dylan Raiola obviously was exciting to see. Danny Kalen was fun to see. Heinrich Harburg's arm strength looks a little bit better this year. And I think Matt Rhule said today also, he's like, listen, we have to feel comfortable going into spring ball with one of those freshmen, or excuse me, going into fall ball with one of those freshmen. There's no like grow up period.
No,
in his mind. And I appreciate that. Right. Cause number one, he's out front and honest. And I think also, Matt was talking to a couple of media people just off to the side, and he was just like, you're here. Like you just got to go. Like there's no like warm up period.
Yeah.
You got to get hit the ground running. And so I think that's a part of it. And I think the quarterback coach helps out quite a bit with that.
But did anybody body wise stick out? You know, usually when you're in this shorts period, I mean, that's about all you can get from it.
I will say, I mean, they were padded up today. Mm-hmm. They had some pads on, I should say. I still Turner Corcoran looked good. Not that he looked much different, but he looked good. He exploded off the ball really well today in one of the drills that I was watching, going against Teddy Prochazka. Made Teddy Prochazka kind of grunt and fall over on one of the drills. Bryce Benhart, you still kind of get shocked because you remember what he looked like early in his career and then how lean he looked last year. Just kind of keeping that same body type. You hope that he has a good final year of his athletic career this year. I think that offensive line is interesting just because you have a guy like Micah Mazuka who's been a couple places. I also didn't realize this. Mazuka's brother, Maurice, is a running back in the room for Nebraska.
Oh, wow.
Did not realize that, that he's been here a couple of years as well, Maurice Mazuka. So offensive line's interesting. Evan Cooper was getting on the guys. I told you guys off air, Tony White's so much fun to watch, just coach.
I got to just stop you real quick. Bryce Benhart, I thought he looked like a mountain.
Yeah, yeah.
He looked good, right?
And I would say the same with Turner. And like we talked about the offensive line depth so much over the last couple of years, and like this is what Nebraska needed. And yeah. Unfortunately, it takes, I think, 2 or 3 years to maybe build the proper depth, but to where Nebraska never, ever, under at least this coaching staff, should have to tell a true freshman coming in, we expect you to play day one.
Why not?
But I'm saying you're saying in the future we should not, because that's what you had to do with Bryce and Turner, and I personally think it set back their career a little bit.
Well, yeah, I mean, you because they were not ready. Young pups in the fire,
and that's my point. Yeah, is so it takes I think 2 to 3 years because. And the reason why is like Sam Sledge is a guy that I look at who in 2 years might be ready to go. And Nebraska had the benefit of not forcing him to or trying to throw him out there last year or even this year, really. Mm-hmm. And so you have to get like 2 or 3 years under your belt of having that ability. And that just takes building a room. You can't just build a room in 1 year. And you might say through the transfer portal and whatever, but I just don't think that's very sustainable.
Did you see the receivers move?
Very little. Okay. Obviously Malachi's in a green jersey. There were some DB drills going on along like the boundaries and stuff, but did not seem to do all that well, according to the coaches' reactions.
Running backs?
Did not see running backs. They were over on a different field that we couldn't maneuver to. There was a ball security drill, and they made one guy. I mean, they made one guy do it, I think, probably I counted 6 times because he kept on messing up every single time. And then you have, you know, the players and you have leaders like Ty Robinson and Gifford going, wake the bleep up and yelling it right at him and calling him out by name. And so, like, that's like accountability pieces that I think you look for in leaders, too.
There's only, listen, if those guys that's in the room don't chastise, help, and get in the face of their teammates and their colleagues, well, we'll be just as like we've been before.
You're going to get it from a coach, but you know, when can you get it from a player? You got to be able to get it from a player. And so that's one, like, obviously on the field, it's going to be great that Ty comes back and Giff comes back and players like that. But now you have Cam Lenhart who needs to step up and kind of take over a leadership role for the future. And you have offensive linemen like a Bryson and Turner and Teddy. Like, Teddy's in what, year 3 or year 4 already? I mean, people forget that
year 4
because he's been so injury prone. Like, just because you can't play on the field because of injuries doesn't mean you can't make an impact on this team. Mm. And I think that's like, all right, time to step up, man. Like, time to be a vocal leader while other guys may be a leader on the field with their pads.
Nick, we appreciate you big time.
Appreciate
you giving us your practice report. Hold on, Nick. We're going to end the show with you, buddy.
I'm lit.
Bach.
And
Nick.
Powered.
By.
Bauer.
Bauer.
Infrastructure.
Bauer.
Underground.
Brand.
Excavating.
Fastest 2 hours in radio is over. We want to thank Nick. We want to thank Cam. We want to thank everybody that made it happen. Thank you, guys. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Hopefully, the black shirt will be in the building. Thanks for riding. Holla at your boy, dog.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
Hi, folks. Sean Callahan here for Koppel Chevrolet GMC, and the Chevrolet and GMC truck month is now underway. We've got huge savings in Louisville. Get $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months on select models. Yes, you heard right. That's $9,000 off or 1.9% for 72 months happening right now at Koppel. So